Surprised to see me?
That's one way of looking at it.
Been waiting long?
20 years.
Together now.
How unfortunate.
You know what I always say in these kind of circumstances?
No, I don't.
It could be worse. You could have toothache.
You're causing a draft.
Well, it's here somewhere, I'm certain.
I was going to give you a twist, but I think we've forgotten it.
I thought you'd remember. Seem to have known Diver. Aren't you curious why I'm here?
I was.
Why are you here anyway? Aren't you curious?
I was.
Well, I've been reading.
Right. Anything interesting?
The entire National Library.
How far have you got?
Well, still in the A section. I brought some of it with me. Look. And, you?
What?
And what have you been up to?
I couldn't possibly reveal my new project to you.
Oh, go on. Go on.
You'll be disappointed.
Look, you've never disappointed me yet. Well, until today.
I've a lot to live up to. What do you mean, until today?
Look, this place is... it's not one of your best ideas. I didn't expect this.
Neither did I.
Tell me what you've been up to while we're apart.
I'm rebuilding the Eiffel Tower.
Right. Well, what's wrong with the original one?
I couldn't fit it into my backyard.
Well, why are you building it?
So I could throw myself off it.
Well, that's not good.
It's better than the alternative. Anyway, why are you here?
Isn't it obvious? Because of the service.
Lousy service.
You know, I think I need more exercise in my life. I'll go for a walk. You know, this place could do a bit of a clean.
So could we.
And a good touching up.
No comment. Better?
I might do that again. Ludwig?
What?
Do you remember what happened before, you know? You ended up here?
I was on my way to get a newspaper. Oh, and 20 boxes of matches. It's a filthy habit, this business. And I stepped onto the train. It went downhill from there.
What, the train?
No, Burnaby, my life.
Well, it's bad for your health. It's inconsiderate to others. It's disgraceful. It's hateful even.
I've wanted to give it up for a long time.
If there's one thing worse than smokers, it's smoking.
I'm not talking about smoking, you fool. I'm talking about existence.
Years, eh? I'd have thought it was my watch that was slow.
Any excuse.
Well, check for yourself if you don't believe me.
Can you explain something to me, Burnaby?
I'll try my best.
Now, don't take this the wrong way.
No, I won't.
Can you tell me, Burnaby, why your watch is nothing but a crude representation drawn along your wrist in what looks like black biro?
No reason.
No reason.
Well, I lost my real watch, and well, since I didn't need a watch because you can get the time from anywhere, I thought I wouldn't waste my money or time.
Right.
Does that make sense?
No.
Would you say I'm winding you up?
No, you've just been a tit.
Well, you know, I kind of miss the security a real watch brings up. I could very well wear a toy watch. That would be daft.
20 years. Maybe more.
Oh, is it out of the question?
Yes. Is what out of the question?
To expect a hug.
Oh, just get on with it.
Oh. Great service.
Lousy service.
Ludwig.
What?
Do you remember the old days?
I'd rather forget.
Hey, we showed them, eh?
No.
We gave it to them.
We didn't.
Whether they liked it or not.
We really didn't.
Whether we wanted to or not.
I didn't want to, I had to.
My memory's not what it was.
My body's going on strike. Some days I feel I could run a marathon, though I know I'd much prefer a 3-hour back rub.
Hey, should we have some sort of gossip while we wait? Hey, there's so much I've missed.
What, while we wait?
While we wait, yes.
It'll have to be gossip.
Do you think we should fashion some sort of gossipy accent? You know, something like, oh, it's bloody awful, everything's so bloody awful.
No. I think you should make fundamental sounds.
Do you think I'd make a fundamental sound if my body dropped dead in the middle of the woods and there was... to the ground, you know, and there was no one there to witness it?
Not unless you said, ah!
What's going to happen, Ludwig?
Knowing my luck, we'll probably have to go through it all again.
Just like Sisyphus.
Now that takes me back.
Yeah. I've missed you. I said I've missed you.
I heard.
Shall we?
If you must.
Ludwig?
No. Yes?
Something's going to happen.
Something normally does.
What do you think we're going to do when all this is over?
I thought it was over.
Oh. Should I tell you a tale?
No.
Is Ludwig.
Right, but can you...
I digress. I can imagine a time when this was a place of happiness. You know, children playing, teenagers in love, music, euphoric screams and laughter.
And yet the ambience is similar to a deserted tram shelter in Blackpool on an overcast day. Seconds before a violent electrical storm.
But do you know where we are?
Isn't it obvious?
Are you homeless?
No comment.
Well, in a way, yeah.
I need to tell my husband.
Well, you should be with people at a time like this.
I live. It's just a few cuts and bruises, nothing that hasn't happened before. We always get stick off the drivers, but it's us who end up on the pavements.
Mangled.
Wait, don't go.
I can't stay.
At least, dance with me.
I don't know how to.
What does this mean, Ludwig?
She's in no fit state to dance, I guess. She also believes that we are at the very least homeless and probably addicted to substances.
You don't know what I'm thinking.
Just let her go.
You're such a people person, Ludwig.
What did you expect from me?
Exactly what I got.
She'll learn.
You know, a hit and run, eh? You know, I don't know why some people can live for themselves. Hello, babe. How was your day?
Oh, you know, nothing special. I just mowed someone down and couldn't be bothered to stop. Anyway, I got that U-brown social art, you know, the real spicy stuff. Put kettle on, love. I'm gasping.
You'd be surprised what some people are prepared to live with.
You don't really believe she thought it was homeless drug addicts, do you?
Well, certainly no worse.
My wife thought I was addicted.
I know, you keep telling me.
It cured itself, though. I'm desensitised now.
I know. And she left you.
Shame. Of all the things I loved about her, it was the smell of her warm body I missed the most.
I'll always remember the long black gloves she wore. There's something rather affectionate about a woman who wears shiny black gloves.
That's my wife you're talking about.
I'm talking about gloves, you fool.
There's nothing for Penny out there now.
There's nothing for her here.
Oh, listen to us. Getting all miserable. Come on. Let's have some fun. It could be worse. You could have to...
If you say that one more time, you'll have no teeth left to ache.
When's it going to happen, Ludwig?
Soon. Never.
I don't suppose this is a dream.
Absolutely not. Only reality is this thing.
But there's someone waiting for me.
You'll soon forget about that. You know, I have a theory about what all of this means.
Oh, do tell.
You forget, Burnaby, that the last big theory I had wasn't exactly a success.
There was nothing out there. I couldn't find anything.
I know. Tell me about it. It's like Warrington.
My family will. I don't know. What's happening?
It's perfectly consistent.
What is...
You were killed, instantly, which is why you are here. They know that.
Who are they?
Yeah, what the heck are you talking about?
You haven't noticed?
Oh, Ludwig, don't be cryptic.
I'm still theorising.
You think I'm dead? I'm dead, that's it, this is some kind of limbo.
No, of course not. That would be too simple, wouldn't it, Ludwig?
It's not limbo.
Then where are we? We're going to see my fucking family!
There's really no point getting angry about it. I've tried. It doesn't make you feel better. Get yourself a hobby.
You could try to make her feel better.
It doesn't get better.
I should tell her what happened to you. That might cheer her up.
I doubt it'll make a difference.
It'll prove that you can be wrong. I mean, well... We're living proof of that, if that makes sense.
I've never been wrong. The truth wasn't what I expected. In fact, there is no truth.
I'll tell her anyway.
You haven't even told me what happened to you.
Well, it's partly your fault I'm here. I was never cut out for research and science.
Don't bring me into this.
I didn't want to stick around after you left. I was always defending you. You know, everyone else was too scared, well, those that survived.
So all this must come as a surprise to you.
Yeah. Shame people are willing to put their lives on the line for this. You know, I could really use some polyfill in this place. And some flowers. I sent you flowers once.
Why did you do that?
Well, that's what people do. At funerals?
It's not as if they could possibly be of any use or comfort to me.
Oh, God. You know, don't let his response shock you, Penny. Gratitude is an alien concept to this distinguished fellow.
I'm just surprised. You could have sent the flowers to someone else. Or something. What kind of flowers were they?
It was spring. Tulips.
Funny.
You like tulips?
I used to. Did you leave a message?
As a matter of fact, I did. Would you like to hear it?
Not especially.
Oh, shame. It was just your sort of thing, you know? A fitting tribute. I kept your options open. Oh well, I guess you'll never know. Oh, the irony.
I get the point. Please, humour me.
My dear Ludwig,
If the unexpected happens and you end up in a place you cannot possibly comprehend, then you have truly reached your own heaven, stroke hell, stroke purgatory, delete as applicable, Barnaby. And then I put a little X at the end, you know. No one's ever explained to me what that little X means, but I assume it must be some kind of informal etiquette.
How did someone like you end up in a place like this?
Well, I was sick of the holy wars, you know. Bored of the emerging war on science. And with you, God, it just didn't seem like the kind of place we're hanging around in. Unless it was on the end of some kind of tight rope. Which is exactly what happened. I thought to myself, just before I jumped off that chair, that I wouldn't have a chance to laugh about this someday. And here I am! You know, it's amazing, I wasn't quite as sceptical as you. I always believed in ghosts. You have to laugh.
Martyrdom doesn't suit you.
Hey, Forbes, I had control. It took a few years to pluck up the courage, let me tell you.
I know what you've done. I hope you're proud of yourself, because you certainly look a Burke. I'm very disappointed.
Is there a bed in this place? I'm feeling strangely tired.
I wouldn't know. It's difficult to sleep.
Try having imaginary interviews with yourself. It always gets me out like a light.
There's a good reason for that.
Oh, good night then.
Don't have nightmares.
Oh, God.
Thinking.
It did look like it.
Don't be obtuse.
Oh, bad daydream then.
Nonsense.
Must have imagined it.
This imagination business is a bad habit.
I was in this hotel. I think it was the manager. It was empty. No, it was this great lavish hotel that was empty. But all the staff were still going about their duties.
In your dream, I presume?
In my dream, yes. But there was this one guest, though. This strange...
Ah! No one saw! No one freaking saw! Bobby! Bloody hell! It's a right shitty! What? At my doctor's, the lady at reception usually turns to someone and says, "You're after her, love."
I don't think we're at the doctor's.
No? Right. What's your name, love, eh?
Penny.
Is that right? That takes me back. It's an old name, that.
I suppose.
Penny. Penny. Never like that name. Is it Penny with a Y or I-N-E?
I-E.
Bet it makes you feel shit, that.
I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
Now, do you? Keep your nose out. Yeah, Penny. Don't like that. What am I going to do without him? They buried my Bobby. 6 foot under. He didn't want to be buried. He's never been right since he worked out Pitt. Have you got a cigarette?
I don't smoke.
He died alone!
It's a fact of death.
You can shut your cake hole. Never could stand that name, Penny. Are you sure you haven't got a cigarette? A dog end will do me.
I haven't, no.
Not one soul could be bothered. Poor Bobby! They should bury you 6 foot under.
I'm sorry if I've upset you.
6 foot under!
What have I said? What have I said?
You can wipe that smirk off your face, young lady. If you're a rum buggy, you'll have all the riffraff round your house. Fighting over everything you've got. Everything you've saved up for. Everything you've scrounged and thieved. Your legs now got a heap of shit on the tip. I know your game, madam. Don't play the little miss innocent pig with me. I've no sympathy.
Look, please, look, we are all in the same boat here.
Got no respect. you know. They reckon he drowned in his own blood. You ever seen anyone drown? I didn't. I was next door having a brew with Pat. I was gone 10 minutes.
Oh.
Don't think I don't know what you're trying to do. I know all about these tall houses and demons. I've done nothing to be ashamed of. I was brought of a good Church of England last May.
The hack is a lunatic.
Don't, Ludwig.
This mayor is insane.
The name's Mary, thank you very much. No need to get naughty.
What a fine job your church has done. Any more like you?
You've got to have an open mind. Perhaps it's up to us, you know, to decide what happens next.
Oh, great. A democratic God.
You should watch your language. You never know who's listening.
This is pointless.
Look, you have a good point there, Penny. You might as well have an open mind. You never know what might happen.
It's already happened.
It might have something to do with karma. I mean, I've never really believed in God or anything like that. But I've always thought there's something to this idea that how you behave and treat other people in your life, or how it affects your next life. It makes sense at the end of the day.
Yeah, at the end of what day? Why do people say that?
Just because you don't have an open mind doesn't mean anyone else's beliefs are any less serious. You shouldn't make fun of them.
Charming?
For all I know, you could all be a figment of my imagination.
I don't see what makes your imagination any more important than anyone else's.
Oh, this is mad! I am not dead!
No, well, whoever's figment it is, it's messed up with irony.
Imagination clouds judgment. It's a distraction.
I wonder if that was someone's imagination. Did anyone hear that?
Hear it? It's bad enough I have you lot to put up with.
For your patience, as you may be aware, you have been assembled here while we process your applications. At the moment, your applications have been placed in a queue and will be dealt with as soon as our operatives become available. Once again, thank you for your patience. In the meantime, please accept some complimentary refreshments.
What the bloody hell are that?
Hey, refreshments? It's a lifetime since I ate that Twix.
This is an automated message. At the moment, you have been placed in a queue. Thank you for your patience.
Does this mean...
It doesn't even make a difference.
Has that happened before, Ludwig? That voice we just heard?
I forget. I think so. I don't know.
It said something about applications being held in a queue.
Oh, it's probably Friday, you know. Maybe the boss is out playing golf somewhere.
Yeah, but who's the boss?
Now that, I can't tell you.
If you ask me, the way some of you lot have been going on, it's bound to end in tears.
Well, no one was asking you. We should just go.
Would you just listen to that? I hope you'll be paying more respect to your host lot, because I tell you this for now, he's not going to stand for any of that. No, I expect he won't be too chuffed with the likes of your sort.
What's that supposed to mean?
You lot have buggered this place up with all your drugs and your kids. It's your generation that's gone soft, laying all these bloody sponges in the country, spreading your muck and diseases about. It's time you faced facts. It weren't perfect when we grew up, but at least we knew where we were and had respect for each other. None of this crossbreeding and running around with needles and knives.
Oh, please. You're an ignorant, senile old woman.
Did you, Dale? Did you? Farewell, rid of you, your kiddies.
Calm down,
ladies. What the bloody hell are you saying?
Not Mary! Mary!
Get your bloody hands off me, you fruitcake!
Now, look. There's no need for that. There's no harm in being civil and making a good impression. We could all be here for a very long time. Ludwig has been here for 20 years, which you know is strange because I'm sure you weren't gone that long.
I wouldn't rule anything out.
But you know different, don't you?
I thought I did, but it seems the rules change.
What do you know, Ludwig? What does Barnaby mean?
Good question. What does Barnaby mean? Let me know when you have the answer.
Is he always like this?
Oh yeah, that's half the fun.
Well, don't you think it's coincidental, the two of you being here like this?
There aren't coincidences.
Well, they might have something to do with fate. This could be all part of some grand design. And there's got to be something bigger than us, bigger than even any rational explanation.
I doubt there's anyone with a bigger ego than the collective human race.
Well, I wasn't talking about ego.
Who else could invent significance?
There must be a reason our minds would operate this way.
I'm sure Barnaby has lots of interesting books on the subject. You should read some of them.
There's no need to patronise me.
Hang on, let's see somewhere. Yeah, this one. Douglas Adams, anyone?
What's your view, Barnaby?
Well, I've already read it.
No.
I don't know, I've read Most and Harmless.
No,
but...
no. I mean about, you know. Oh, never mind.
Ludwig!
You cold?
Red?
Your pint being?
Red?
I can see some sort of pattern beginning to emerge here. What does it smell like?
Bread?
Thank goodness for that. For a while you almost had me worried.
I wasn't looking for it.
Well, it found you.
It wasn't there before. It could have been, I suppose, but...
The problem with you, Barnaby, is you only see what your heart wants your eyes to see. You have no sense of foresight, whereas I see things with my mind.
Do you think it's safe to eat?
Not unless it's been poisoned, in which case I hope there's enough to go around.
Can we eat?
Well, it has been said that man can't live by bread alone.
Who said that?
I did.
Is it off?
It smells nostalgic.
Nostalgic, eh? I've never heard a water being described as nostalgic before.
You obviously haven't tried this water.
That'll be the refreshments they laid on, then. Bit stingy. You think they would have put on some pork pies and sausage rolls? Would it have killed them to lay on a bit of rum and black?
Wait, can I try some of that? My mouth feels dry.
Be my guest.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
It's vodka!
Give me that!
Take it. Here, let me.
It's okay, I could manage.
But I insist it was my fault!
There's really no need!
Look, this wouldn't have happened if it had been lemon tea!
It's okay! I've got some Lucozade in my bag somewhere. We can share this if you like.
Oh, well, hey, that's thoughtful of you. Won't be awful, it.
I shouldn't think so. I only got it this morning. Oh, well, I don't know now.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Hey, that's not the way to consume vodka.
It's the only bloody way. You don't muck about with this stuff.
So I see. All right, then, you've had your turn. There are others to consider.
I've not got frigging rabies!
Now that is what I call nostalgic.
Manners.
I thought you'd never offer anything that eases the burden of contemplation.
I had you down as one of those teetotal freaks.
That's quite a gift you have, you know, making snap judgments. It'll get into trouble one of these days. Come, give it here.
They don't come much more straight talking than me. Even my Bobby had his moments. Not that he's any use now. I'm 6 foot under.
If it's any consolation to you, I think that along with the soil and the creepy crawlies, he's in marginally better company than we are.
I don't know about her, but is he always like this after a couple of sips of vodka?
I didn't even know he drank.
That's a nice model. I noticed it when we came in. It's a bit rude though, but you know what the French are like.
They say that about all man-made vertical structures. It's like... That's a phallic symbol. That's a phallic symbol. As if buildings are never made for economy of space, aesthetical, practical or functional reasons. I'd love to know what feminist made of Liebeskind.
What are you on about?
Ironically, he's a very small man.
Is
he's probably telling us some facts about the Eiffel Tower. How it stands 986 feet high, 1,058 feet high if you include the antenna. He'll assume that she'll already know about the time for its construction in 1889, or the fact that it's actually the second highest structure in France, the highest being the Allouez one-way transmitter, which was built in 1939. But what she might not know is that the total weight of the tower is 10,100 tonnes, and that's before you fill it full of American tourists. Then there's a small matter of the 1,665 steps, or that depending on the temperature, the tower sometimes shifts 8 centimetres away from the sun due to the expansion of the metal. Yeah, it's safe quoting facts and figures. You can get all that passion out of it having to give anything of yourself away. But you do really, you know, which is why you might have heard the business of the 50 tonnes of paint being splashed on the tower every 7 years. Our 300 workers joined together 18,038 pieces of puddled iron, which is a very pure form of structural iron, using 2.5 million rivets in a structural design by Maurice Kirkman. Now, what I always found interesting is that it's a great Hollywood cliche that the view from a Parisian window always includes a view of the tower. Because in reality, due to so many restrictions that only limit most of the buildings in Paris to a few stories tall, only some of the taller buildings have a clear view of the tower.
One word, wow.
I don't know much about architecture.
You know plenty about the Eiffel Tower.
Thank heavens, Wikipedia.
Don't you think it's weird though?
A bit misinformed sometimes, but I won't say weird.
No, I mean, being here, you know, us, this place. One minute it feels like everything's wrecked, you know, my life, my hopes, my future. And the next, natural and normal, like it's always been like this. I know I sound crazy, but it feels like I'm outside of myself.
You know, for me, it made sense as soon as I emerged. You know, when I saw Ludwig, I wasn't surprised, as if it was only last month I saw him. It's always been my reference point, really. I don't really remember much about my childhood. Other than my mother never took any photographs of me. She had this strange idea that they were cursed, like every photo had the meaning to be the last reference of your life or something like that. I don't really know what she meant.
No, I know what she means. Like when a child gets murdered and they show the last known picture on the news and it always looks, you know, uncanny. What do you miss most right now?
Barnaby.
You're saying you miss yourself?
No, my dog Barnaby. He was a beagle. He used to be called the Beagle too, but that's a daft name for a dog.
You're a strange pair, if you don't mind me saying. What's your story?
Oh, nothing really. We're just a couple of nutters. Hey, you know that Lucas, eh? Takes me back.
And that's why those who haven't really stayed in Paris get this sentimental idea that every window view contains the tower as its backdrop.
You don't have to worry about me, you know. I won't crush it. You'll be a bit of a smart ass before, but there's a good reason why I won't do out to it.
Could that be because I'd stamp on your mouth if you tried anything?
If my Bobby heard you say that, he'd dunk your glasses down the back of your throat. No. It reminds me of Marcel Marceau. I met him once. It were a few years ago now. I were in Paris with my Bobby. We'd won a competition, you know. Something in woman's own. Honest to God, he spent most of the weekend moaning and taking the mick out of everyone. Talk about showing me up. I felt awful. We were in this one bar when all of a sudden he turns to me and he says, I don't want to do this anymore.
Who? Marcel?
No, Bobby, you daft lump. I've not met Marcel yet.
Right.
Yeah, he says, I'm not being funny around, but we're no good for each other. I think we should jack it in when we get back. I'm like, jack it in? You're not jacking anything in. You don't get out of it that easily. Anyway, even though we've been together for the best part of 27 years, we knew nout about each other. But I'm not good enough for him, am I? Gone and found himself a dolly bird from Oldham. Some right good time girl called Joyce. Probably a Blackpool type.
Blackpool? I don't follow.
Well, everyone's been to Blackpool, haven't they? Anyway, I wasn't having none of it. I just went for a walk, a think, and a cig. Got myself lost. Didn't matter. I stopped at the edge of the curb. Probably wanted to throw myself in front of a car. I had now to go back to. And then I saw him.
Marcel?
No, Johnny bloody Halliday. Of course it was Marcel Marceau. I could see his shape out the corner of my eye. I turned round and he was there in front of me. And then guess what happened?
He pushed you in the road?
No, silly. He just smiled at me, looked at me once more, and then walked off. I felt really warm inside. Like, I was, I was loved, really loved. I'll never forget that.
What have I done, Barnaby?
Is he all right?
It's the vodka.
I had it all.
Red, bring that bread. Maybe that'll sort that stuff up.
Evidence, answers, proof, agreements.
What's he talking about?
He can't take his drink.
Yeah, Ludwig, you must eat this.
It's stale.
Eat!
It's all a sham. One big pointless waste of time.
Look, Ludwig, you have to put that business behind you.
Imagine it. You have it all there. It gives you no joy to have solved the mystery. Then after years of research, updating, backing up claims, you have to share your information with the world. The burden.
What does he mean?
I proved and had the scientific evidence that God in all its forms didn't exist.
Codswallop.
What evidence?
I was about to publish my findings in layman's terms in every conceivable language the world over. It would have made sense. You remember, don't you, Barnaby?
I remember.
Tell them what happened.
Do I have to?
Tell them.
Haven't you said enough? They need something to believe in.
That's why you should tell them.
Someone tell us.
Just as he was about to make his findings known, he died.
You could call it an assassination.
Fundamentalists.
That's your Arabs for you.
It wasn't an Islamic fundamentalist. The head that was facing me on the train belonged to a young white woman.
Rubbish. How do you know it had anything to do with that poor woman?
She looked at me, smiled, and said, I forgive you.
I don't see what's so funny.
It's the best life I've had in a long time. He's wasted his life. He was wrong. I forgive you. Aya, say it again.
It might not be about being right or wrong.
Look at him. He's made a right cock up. And what about him? He hangs around you like a shite hawk. Oh, he's not gonna like that him up there. He's gonna go up the ruddy pearl. You're gonna get a big fat red rejected stamp on your application. There's no two ways about that. You won't be walking up the golden path.
It might not be about gods and toll houses and golden paths and things like that.
You would say that. You believe in all that mumbo jumbo. I bet you've got one of those thingies, one of those dream catchers and that feng shui shit and what have you rubbish. You're probably one of them gap year slackers with your drugs, your charity shop skirts and your hocus pocus medicine.
It's irrelevant now.
You'd have been a lot better if you just kept your mouth shut. All those poor miserable sods on the train. It's murder.
Really?
It's not right going round breaking folks' hearts.
You know, is that so?
Here.
You know this? It upset a lot of people for a while. They said it was an eyesore, but, you know, eventually, people came to respect and love it. If you don't mind being lied to and deceived to all your life, then fine. But don't deny others a chance to explore. You know, it's people like you that don't upset the status quo, but that don't rock the boat philosophy, which has truly run this world into the ground. It's not about upsetting people, but enlightening them. Truly enlightening them. And, well, you shouldn't say those things. You just shouldn't say them.
You were telling me about your dream, Barnaby. The hotel.
Yeah, we were interrupted.
Tell you what, love. There's something queer about those two.
Yeah.
If you get my meaning. You know, like that.
For Christ's sake.
Don't get me wrong, love. There's nothing wrong with that. But not on your doorstep, eh? I were no saint, but the nights were lonely. Men don't have the same needs, do they, love? Eh? Of course not.
I wouldn't know.
In my day, we kept ourselves to ourselves. It's not easy, though, is it, when your husband or your dad go off to fight? It's not easy for both of you. You get lonely, no matter where you are. Everyone was at it. Not as much as they are these days, but you know what it's like. Too much of it in your face these days. That's why you have your cancers and your epidemics. But in those days, you had to make your own entertainment. None of your computer games and your mobile phones. We didn't have a telly till 1969. My Auntie Irene and my mum looked after me. I weren't daft though. I knew what really went on. I was 14 when I found it in Irene's bedroom. 10 a penny at Aunt Summer's nowadays, but in those days you had to improvise. I'm just saying, what with all that's going on and them two at it, there's no reason why we can't keep each other company. You say you can't take out with you, but who'd have thought it?
Right.
What would turn your nose up at that? Oh, that's a nasty bruise. Do you want me to rub it better?
Oh, fine, thank you.
For a moment there, I could have sworn.
Is he going to be all right?
Oh, it'll take more than half a bottle of vodka to finish him off. But what about her?
She's in desperate need of a cigarette. What about your dream?
Oh, that. You know, it was about this great lavish hotel where no one stays except for this mystery guest. I think in the dream I'm the manager, but all my staff keep disappearing every time they go into the guest room. And every now and again, people from outside the hotel come in to see the guest and or to deliver things. But they never return. It's like they're giving up a moment of their lives just to spend it in the presence of the guest. No one has seen the guest, no, but everyone knows about the guest, you know. You know, they only have to know about that room. It's enough for them, really. After a while, I take the lift. And I find myself in this really long corridor. And as I'm about to reach the door at the end of the corridor, the door opens and I'm about to enter. And I wake up in tears.
You're unhappy?
No, the total opposite. I've never been happier. But upon awakening, it's like I'm missing something.
Your beagle?
I really don't know.
Has anyone got 50p for the meetup?
Thank you.
Just for once, once only, it would be nice never to wake up again.
But it's all changed, look!
So it has.
I've always hated beaches.
All right, Wilfred. What do you say?
Slut.
Well, I'm not in the mood now. What's really going on? What's the matter?
I'm ashamed.
Right? Why?
Of how we used to treat the girls.
What girls?
All the girls.
Do you really think you should be telling me this?
I might as well. I wouldn't want people thinking I'm dependable Barnaby. I behave despicably. My mum and dad once put this woman and a 4-year-old daughter. They've been having a hard time with her father. He used to knock them around, and all I ever did to that little girl was make her life hell.
I don't think I want to know.
But you must if we're to become good friends.
Tell me you didn't.
I did. I made faces at her.
You made faces at her?
Yeah. Oh, I did.
And that's what you're upset about?
Well, it's not nice.
Well, how old were you?
10, 11.
And you just made faces at her?
You didn't see the look of terror in her eyes.
Well, why did you do it?
She just had one of those faces I didn't like.
You were an only child?
Well, my sister was killed in a road accident when she was 3. I was about 7.
Shit.
You know, brothers are supposed to look out for the sisters, aren't they? But I made sure that every day she breathed would be terrifying.
I'm sure it wasn't like that. You were young.
Every time I saw happiness on her face, I just felt more hatred and jealousy.
I'm sure it wasn't like that. You were 7.
I was young enough to know better.
You were to know what was going to happen.
I remember a face just before that motorbike hit her. She used to look at me in the same way. You know, for years after, I would have given anything to change places with her. You know, and for years after that, you know, I tried to avoid every woman I came into contact with. I tried to scare them away, you know, partly for the attention. I got into relationships that I knew would end up getting me hurt, which is, you know, fair, I suppose.
Did you have any kids?
No, it never happened.
We're coping, you know, with you. It's cool. It's the here and now that matters.
Yeah. And, you know, when it wasn't girls, it was pets.
I don't get you.
Well, my dog, I neglected it. Well, on my auntie's cat, I used to swing it about.
That's sick!
Can you believe this? The bloody cheek of it!
What?
They've only gone and charged me full price for 2 blocks of best butter, but they knew full well it was on a bog off.
And for your patience, you are now in the penultimate stage of your application process. Our observation is not currently assessing your application. We will contact you shortly when we have made our decision. In the meantime, you cannot hesitate to take full advantage of the facilities we have provided for you. Once again, thank you for your interest and your patience.
Are you going for a dip?
I had my suspicions even before Mary's story about the mime artist.
What's he on about now?
Let's take your story about the mime artist first, shall we? The circumstances of your encounter with Marcel Marceau.
Are you calling me a liar?
Oh, I'm not saying it didn't happen. The problem, however, is it didn't happen to you.
You were calling me a liar.
I can't quite work that one out. But unless Marcel Marceau is in the habit of bumping into women in Paris, just as they're on the verge of losing it, then I may be wrong, but your story is almost identical to the story of an actress who made a similar observation, as recounted by the Polish director, Kieslowski.
He's off his head!
I can see the attraction. It's a nice, life-affirming little tale. Almost a moving account, really. It gets you a bit of sympathy.
even gives you, dare I say it, substance and depth. As with the anecdote, it brings into focus this theory about fate, that maybe all of Mercer's life, all his performances, work and art, were meaningless compared to saving you. That in effect, he lived for that moment. It's a nice romantic idea. I can see the attraction.
It's true.
It's not your truth.
What are you on?
I think he's trying to imply that you're not real.
Not necessarily.
Of course I'm bleeding real. Sometimes I wish I were, but you don't know out about me and Bobby.
No, we don't know anything about Bobby.
Now do you?
You probably haven't ever even been to the house.
Cheeky get.
Where are you going with this?
And this place, does it remind anyone of something?
Well, even you must have been to a beach before.
No, it hasn't. I have. This place reminds me of Nice. I used to tell him about it all the time.
The point I'm trying to make is that everything seems too elaborate or coincidental. One minute I'm alone for what feels like an eternity. The next I'm dealing with people and automated voices. I'm betting there are more coincidences. I'm sure there are.
What does this mean if there are?
It may mean that I had it right. Everything started to fit into some kind of logic. You know, before your return, I actually doubted my own sanity.
Coma?
No, as you know, I've never wished to be kept alive.
Well, people lie.
People do lie, yes. You're not seriously suggesting I'm lying in a coma, are you?
No. Look, I'm just making sure we've got everything covered, but there was nothing left of you, well, mostly nothing.
And that was that. It was instant.
An instant could be an eternity. A millisecond of intense, flesh-burning, bone-smashing agony could be just as painful as the electric chair or relief from injection.
I don't think it's a competition. Every death has its own pitfalls, as well as the inevitable split-second realisation that you'd wish you'd been invited to more parties at university.
You must have only had a second or two to get used to the news, you know. Mostly when people are told or expect tonight, it could be months or years. But they have a chance to rationalise things, you know, put it into perspective. How do you make sense of all that in mere seconds?
You two jokers are a right barrel of laughs.
But this is serious.
Why is it so important to you what I physically and mentally went through?
I'm fascinated. You had no control. You know, when I tried to control it, I ended up thinking to myself, oh, this hanging business wasn't such a good idea. I should have taken some pills.
It was a stupid thing to do.
Yeah, the coward's way out. Him upstairs won't be impressed with that.
I've always been scared of the idea of death rather than death itself. I remember the first time I became aware that one day I would die. I was watching The Snowman. And there's that bit near the end where you can see it in the boy's eyes when he bounds up and gives the snowman one last hug before he looks at him for the last time. It always upset me more than when he finds him the next morning, nothing more than a mound of snow.
Claptrap.
Well, what's your view then?
How should I know? I wasn't brought up to think about that. There's nothing to be scared of.
Say you had a day left to live. What should you do?
I wouldn't do out.
But what should you do?
It depends.
Depends on what?
The kind of person you are.
What does that have to do with anything?
A lot, really. Your personality will undoubtedly affect your approach to such a dilemma. You could spend your remaining hours in total shock, unable to speak or move. I'm sure many would answer with the usual pointless public house philosophy of spending the rest of the day getting drunk and making love.
Well, true, but I'm talking here and now with hindsight as a guide. I'm talking should not, would or could.
Answers on a postcard, anyone?
If you're religious, you might want to pray and be with your loved ones.
Yes, but should you? Well, should we do that?
I know what I should have done if I'd have known. I'd have settled a few scores and make no mistake. The neighbours would have got theirs. They've been nothing but cheeky and nasty since the day they moved in. That trollop would get what's coming to her. Oh, her laugh! How she laughs! How she shrieks! It can cut through walls! There wasn't a day passed by since she moved in when I haven't thought about taking Bobby Stanley knife to that warbling throat of hers. Her kids are cheeky little toe rags as well. Always punching her ball around at all hours of the night. They've never even seen her back. And when he's on nights, that tart is always at it with some Jack the lad. She wouldn't even know if someone snatched them kids and left the poor buggers for dead. No, I've no sympathy for her type. If they want to live in their own filth, then that's up to them.
I should have stayed to defend Ludwig's work. You see, Ludwig, I deleted your copies, your research, everything. I took your findings to the grave. I was scared of what would happen if your work got out. The impact it would have on people whose spiritual belief was a positive thing. I wanted you to be wrong, Ludwig.
My man. Don't you feel like a piss pot?
Say something.
Green or brown?
Straight here.
hold out much hope for them. Not with him topping himself and that queer and getting a lot of innocents killed. No. Jesus will save us. You'll see. He'll sort it out. Won't you, Lord? Won't you? Won't you? Won't you save me, Jesus? Won't you? Save me, Jesus! Save me! Won't you? Save me! Won't you? Won't you love me? Won't somebody love me?
What is that pathetic sound?
It's called guilt, Burnaby.
A decision has been made. Murray Gore, we regret to inform you that your application has been unsuccessful.
What?
Please follow the signal. You will find a guide at the end of the light.
But I haven't done nothing. What do you mean, regret? I went to church most weeks. I'm good. Is this what you should be regretting? It's all he's doing! Take him! Take them all! Take all them bastards who didn't come to see Bobby off!
The decision has been made. Murray Gore, we regret to inform you that your application has been unsuccessful. Please follow the signal. You will find a guide at the end of the light.
What will happen to her?
There's no point talking to that thing. It's hardly going to reply.
What will happen to me? You said there was something fishy about all this.
I said I had my suspicions.
What were they?
As I understand it, all of these...
A decision has been made. Murray Gore, your application was unsuccessful. Follow the fucking signal. You can't miss it. It's a long, sharp, bright shaft of fucking light.
Look, don't worry, Murray. It could be worse. You could have toothache. It was nice to meet you.
Goodbye, Mary. I hope you find some peace.
You were interesting.
Bobby? Is that?
Well, that's that.
Where do you think she is?
Who cares?
You know, if you've got any ideas, Ludwig, about to get us out of this situation, now would be a good time.
If this is a good time, then my mind boggles at what would constitute a bad time.
The thing that really gets to me is that I didn't make the most of all the obvious things. Like really, really loving them, and really, really holding on. Spending a week looking, really looking into the eyes of my husband and telling him and my son just how much I love them. And just being grateful for having my health and security, you know, all of the things that...
What matters to you, eh? Come on, you never say what matters. Or is it, no, is it this pathetic thing?
Put that down.
You care about this thing?
Come on, leave this out of it.
Look, we'll... Tell me, Master, what does this thing represent to you? Is it pride? Ambition? Truth? Ambition? Imagination?
Barnaby!
Come here with that!
Look at me! I'm a little boy with a toy! You can't catch me!
Ooh. Put that down!
I don't want to!
This is nonsense!
I know!
Just give it back to me!
Barnaby, please give it back to him!
You're destroying my life's work!
Sue me!
I've had enough of this! All of this, so sick of it. Books, pages, words, ideas, images, theories, facts, fiction, hate all of it. Hope, feelings, problems, answers, rubbish, self-indulgent, self-important, self-righteous,
vomit! Education absolutely useless in a world that worships stupidity and privilege!
What are you doing? Both of you!
You're some kind of bastard!
If only I were!
Stop it, dickhead!
Oh, don't hold back, Penny. You know what I'm really like.
A decision has been made, Penny Harris. We are pleased to inform you that your application has been successful. Please follow the signal. You will find a guide at the end of the line.
No!
It's all right, Barnaby. I have a good feeling.
I don't want you to go.
Will you two be all right without me?
I'm sure we can find a happy medium.
Oh, he means yes.
A decision has been made, Penny Harris. We are pleased to inform you that your application has been successful. Please follow the signal. You will find a guide at the end of the light.
I'll let you know what it's like.
Send us a postcard.
Oh, don't be a stranger. Oh, wait, Penny, wait. What about that dance?
I don't know how to dance. Good luck. I'll miss you. I'll miss both of you.
No, no, Barnaby, my friend. This is no way to carry on.
I'm sorry about your model. I know how much it meant to you.
I know. I was angry at Father. I never did get it finished.
What's going to happen to us?
Nothing will happen to you.
I don't want to become nothing.
You'll always be something.
I only wanted to dance. I've never danced with anyone.
Do you know how to dance?
You need music.
You don't need anything. Just your imagination.
Thought you didn't have any.
I think I can rebel just this once. Anyway, what are you waiting for? I'm not going to offer this again. No. Follow me, okay. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. You know me.
Well, I knew you. Ludwig, I just wanted to say...
Go! Please.
You know, this might make you feel sick, but I find myself thinking about the snowman.
Remodeled.
The trust should be able to accommodate multiple residents and investors.
What about the current resident?
I should think he'll be euthanised, digitised and recycled unless his benefactor can provide additional investment.
My guardian said that in the times I'd passed, our service provided care and rehabilitation rather than recycling and retention.
Let's not have this tired debate again. If your guardian's contemporaries had been efficient, competent and cost-effective and fostered multi-streams of investment in the care sector, then we may now have the luxury of retention, rehabilitation and real-time care. Instead, we can thank them for the legacy of targets, think tanks, turnovers and quotas to fulfil. Well, what is it?
Oh, pardon, I was looking at the date of our current resident here. Interesting.
That is not relevant to the audit. Now let us consider the energy efficiency.
Is he aware of our presence?
Probably. Anyway, the energy forecast for the current...
What's he going to do with those?
Considering the case history of our current resident, is it appropriate that he's allowed to have these materials with him?
Are they safe?
Of course they are safe. Anyway, we must press on. We have more compartments to visit.
Psychosis. The subject's fantasies refrained from being a Nobel Prize-winning physicist, a polar explorer, an Olympic cyclist, to being part of an experiment undertaken by futuristic researchers.
Remind me what we are doing here, assistant.
To do an audit.
What do you think triggered the psychosis?
According to this, there's a bit to go on. While the notes and therapy can't claim to know for sure, library burned down, blah, blah, blah. Oh, the suicide Barnaby.
Barnaby?
His son, following the closure of the local library, where he worked.
Can we make progress, please?
Is he married?
To Mary. She's a benefactor.
May I remind you that this information is not to be shared unless authorised by the trust and the authority.
Who is he being treated?
The usual, medication, exercise and lots of rest.
You needn't concern yourself with the case history of the resident or how the trust will seek to accommodate him once the new laws have been passed. We must move on. He cannot respond. Our presence here is redundant.
We are redundant. Did you get that? We don't exist. Can you see me?
You know that this is out of the question. I'm going to have to report your behaviour to your guardian.
What? He blinked.
Of course he blinked. He's alive. We are not here to interfere. Come now. I want us to look at the humidity levels in the compartment adjacent to this one.
Humidity levels?
Not humidity levels.